I heard stories of, you know, the Italian mob used to try to shake down Albanian families, and it would never end well for the Italians. They would never, they would try to come, like if a guy opened up a store on Arthur Avenue, and they'd come with that, you know, you got to pay this, you got to pay that, and the Albanians would be like, fuck you. Is that true? To your knowledge?
Yeah, without me mentioning some of the Albanian family names that
I've heard these stories from the horse's mouth. I just want to cooperate because you're on the other side over there.
Here's the things with Albanians, and you know this, and Albanians that are listening know this. If you disrespect an Albanian, especially an Albanian's old culture, right, if they're real.
They'd rather die.
They'd rather die than pay. And there's stories with legitimate guys. There's a guy that was from Jamaica Avenue. He owned a jewelry store.
Yeah, no names. I don't want no beef.
And they came to rob him. And they, you know, when they robbed him, they put a gun to his head. They put a gun to his wife's head. And he still wouldn't give it up. And it's not a tough guy. He's a legitimate, just an old school Albanian.
Hard-working.
And they told him, if you don't give it, we're going to kill your wife. He says, kill her. And he loved his wife. Don't get me wrong.
But he was ready to die.
He was ready to die.
Because his manhood.
So they shot his hands. And they thought by shooting his hands, they shot his fingers off, that he would pay. He didn't pay. And they end up leaving. They took whatever, a little bit, but they didn't get into his safe. They came back a couple of months later, 3, 4, 6 months later. They shot him again, and he wouldn't give it up. And I left, and I was very friendly with his son. And his son, again, very educated, nice kid, not a gangster, neither was the father. And they asked to see me, and I went to see him, and he was told me what happened, and he described who came. And we went to see him, and they wanted something done about it. And this is a legitimate guy, and we never did anything about it, couldn't find the guys. And the story be told afterwards, one out of the three guys end up dead. Now, who killed them, I don't know. But this will show you about, this is just a typical hardworking Albanian that ran a business that wasn't a gangster, wasn't a street guy. But the mentality, you know, as the Albanians that are listening know.
I heard a lot of these stories.
You're not going to get away with doing that to an Albanian guy overall. I mean, I guess there's pockets of people that don't want any kind of trouble. And then you get guys like him that says he's a hardworking guy, his family legitimate people, his son was a nice kid, educated, but they weren't going to allow anybody to take advantage of him. So I think that's a lot of our culture is the same beliefs I have in my heart. People ask me, well, you know, about some of the decisions I made. I said, nobody's going to take advantage of me. Nobody's going to make a sucker of me. And nobody is going to go against me the way they did and expect loyalty back from guys that gave me no loyalty. And guys that betrayed me. It's never going to get changed. And that's why I've never shut up since I've been out of jail. I said, because I never betrayed anybody. I've been betrayed. And that is never going to get twisted. Because factually, we can check dates on this.